In this tutorial, I will show you the features of the web server. Karel provides a webkit that is a website demo. Basically, it is a showroom of the Cpico web features. We deliver it in source code that is written in standard HTML and CSS stylesheets and JavaScript without the need of special plugins. You can download it from KSA in the template area. Here is WebKit. La test version is this one. There is also a tutorial that explains you how to modify it. Probably it's better to see in the slides. So these are some screenshots of the manual. So shows the structure of the pages, what you can modify. It contains also an example of how to create a custom page with a background, how to show the values or the variables in the page, and other important information. Well, so how to use it? You have to download the WebKit from KSA and copy it in a folder called HTTP of the internal public memory of the controller. You can copy the files via FTP or connecting the USB cable. You can see it as a disk and copy as you copy in a pen drive. And this is what I'm going to do. So I'm connecting the PC to the Cpico. Here is the memory of the controller. So I have to create a folder called HTTP and copy here inside the WebKit. So let's download it. Copy all the files in the controller. Okay. So this is the memory of the controller, HTTP folder and the files. Now open the browser and type the IP of the controller. Ten, one, two. What's wrong here? Just read the message. There are two possibilities. In that controller, there isn't the index HTML folder in file in the HTTP folder, but it's not so because I have just copied it. We can check. So HTTP index. So this is not the problem. The problem is the other. Make sure that the USB cable is disconnected. Why? Because the HTML files are in the public flash memory, but in this moment, since the PC is connected to the Cpico, that memory is mounted as a disk. This one. So the web server is not able to access to that memory. So as we've seen also in a previous tutorial, the solution is simply disconnect the cable. So the operating system and so the web server will be able to access it. So I am disconnecting the cable. Now just try again. And here is. This is the home page. So there is a picture of the controller. There is a menu bar, also a side menu bar. There is a logo, a description, but as I told you before, you can modify almost everything of this page and also the other pages. We can start to see the content of the other pages. Demo will be seen at the end. PGD is the PGD web that we have used a lot of times before. These two buttons are used to simulate the pressure of two buttons for a short period, and while this is a two button for a long period, for 2 seconds, like to enter in the system menu. Okay, we've already seen as many times this page, so we can go to the next. Variables. This shows the variables that we have selected in the application in CDesign. In the Terra Web Editor, in this column. So you see that you can, for each variable, you can disable or set read-only or read-write. So all the variables that here are read or read-write will be visible in that page. This is a sort of a very simple supervisory system, because not graphical, but textual and as a table, but it is working. For example, we can change the set point to 11 degrees, set, and here is it is changed. We can see also from the PGD web, here is 11 degrees, 11.4, 11.4. Next, alarms. Here you have this is the log of the alarms. Fresh. So here is another alarm. We can reset the active alarms. It is possible to wipe the history of the alarm. And this is still active. Okay, wipe and it goes away. Antifreeze. Next, nest stats. This page shows diagnostic information, not very interesting for now, so we can continue with the logger. And this is one of the most interesting feature. There are two types of logs. There are live logs and data logger. In the live logs, the system shows the current value of the variable, while the other shows the values that comes from the internal data logger. We start from this. First of all, we have to select the variables we want to show. We can show the temperature. So the inlet water temperature, okay, it was already selected. And the compressors, okay, already selected, probably I selected in a previous exercise. After that, hide and start. So these are their live values. Increase the temperature. Up, up, up. Down. So we can zoom. Probably if you play with this, you can understand how this works. You can change the color, the description of the axis, temporarily enable disable the rendering of some variable. You can also save the current values. For example, if there are problems, some problems on the site, you can go there, you can start to log. After maybe 1 hour, 2 hours, you stop, you can save the values into a file that you can bring to your office, and with calm you can analyze. Well, so now the temperature is 12.61, 12.5 more or less. Let's check here. 12.5 more or less. Next is the data logger, log data logger. So in this case, the system shows the values that comes from one of the running logs. So that are the ones that we have uploaded, configured and then uploaded here in the log editor. So the log of temp and log of comp. Here is log of temp and log of comp. So we can select one. We can select the period from two. There are also some presets. So the last day, the last 2 days, the last weeks, and so on. And load. So now the page is inquiring the controller. The controller sends the value, and here is. So these are the values of the internal cataloger. Also in this case we can change the color and all other properties, and like before to save. Okay, now I'm changing the temperature to see if later we have some new values in the trend. Okay, so I went up and down. Load again. Here is the temperature going up and down. Well, next upgrade. We already seen in the previous tutorial. With this we can upload application package, upgrade package into the controller. So we have to create the upgrade package with the C factory, select it, and then upload. For a live demo, you can see the previous tutorial. We can go to the next, upload. With upload, you can load generic files, any kind of files. It will save in a folder called HTTP transfer. For example, you can upload a file containing the parameters, new parameters of the unit, and then load it using the import. I'll try to show using the import param feature. Next and last is the demo. This is a demo page. This is the demo page that we used in one of the last exhibitions. This page feature of a background. We show somewhere the values of some variables, supply fan. So this page is not for the chiller application of our exercises, but for an demo air end unit. There are links to pages showing the trends of exhaust temperature, supply fan temperature, and so on. It's possible to switch on, switch off the unit. So, how to customize it? For example, we can show somewhere here in the top left corner the value of the water inlet temperature. The manual states that we have to change two parts of the HTML pages, page. In the first part, we have to define the list of the variables we want to show in the page with some properties like the unit of measure, the number of decimals, and in, the, in another section, where to show it, the variable and the position, and also in this case, some other properties. So somewhere in the source file of the page, there is the list of the variables and then the position. So let's modify it. I can't modify this file directly from here, so I will download it. So now I connect via FTP. It is the same to connect using the USB cable. So the file is a custom page, so copy, I can open using, that is a very simple modification, so rather than use a commercial or a specific editor, I will edit with Notepad. So step one, the list of the variables. The variable is called water inlet temperature. You can measure Celsius degree, that's good. Decimals, one. And then where, copy and paste, so the water in temperature, top 20 pixel, left 20 pixel, basically is the top left corner, and the description, water. Okay, that's all. Save, copy back into the controller. Close the source, reload, here is the temperature. 7, okay, let's have to check why it is flashing. Well, in this tutorial we have seen what are the features of the web server, we've seen where to download the WebKit and what are the features. Well, I spent a few minutes to show you the WebKit, but I think that you agree that it is a very important feature. Last words. So there are two ways to create web pages. The first is how we just saw, that is create pages using any editor in HTML, CSS and JavaScript. The other option is use a specific tool called CWeb. This is a curl tool. Here is the editor, so this is a graphical editor, so you can modify, customize it, not modifying the HTML file, but in a graphical way. So there are libraries of widget that you can place, you can bound to the project variables, and so on. So the CWeb editor is out of the scope of this tutorial. For this there is a specific training, and I believe that in the future also a specific set of tutorial. Well, that's all for this tutorial, where we have seen what are the features of the web server, and where to download the WebKit, what are the features of the WebKit, and how to modify it. Thank you for watching.